In this video, I'm going to discuss what is viscoelasticity and why polymeric material shows viscoelastic behavior. I will also discuss the simple viscoelastic models and their simplified equation, which can be very helpful in solving exam questions. So let's first discuss what is viscoelasticity. Viscoelasticity is a type of deformation which consists of both elastic and viscous deformation. Elastic deformation is a recoverable deformation, which means the sample or the material can return to its original shape once the applied force is removed. Whereas, viscous deformation is a non-recoverable deformation, which means applied force leads to a permanent deformation of the sample. The example of elastic deformation is stretching of rubber bands. An example of viscous deformation is flow of fluids, like water or honey. It seems odd that polymers are solid at room temperature, but they may deform like a liquid. Before going into why it will deform like liquids, let first discuss how polymers deform under stress. Here, we can see that at a small deformation, stress increases linearly with strain. This region is called elastic region, and deformation is called elastic deformation, because sample can return to its original shape if the force is removed. But once the deformation reaches to yield point, sample starts to deform permanently. After yield point, the deformation is called viscous deformation. And here we can see that deformation is occurring without increasing stress. Now, let's discuss why polymeric material shows both elastic and viscous deformation. Here, I'm not going to get into the in-depth analysis of the molecular mechanism or use mathematical model to explain the deformation behavior. But I will discuss some key parameters and I will provide a general understanding of molecular motion responsible for the viscoelastic behavior. Those who are interested to learn more about the molecular mechanism, a reference is provided in the slide. In my previous video, Introduction to Polymer, I have provided some explanation and example of how polymeric material differ from other chemical and metallic materials. The major difference is polymeric materials consist of long chain molecules. As a result, in addition to chemical forces like ionic, van der Waals, and non-polar interactions, polymer chain also interact through entanglement points. In a semi-crystalline polymer, crystals also act as an entanglement point. Another point which is different in polymeric material is a polymer chain can have motion at different time scale, from atomic vibration to full chain diffusion. This mobility occurs at different time scale. Diffusion of large segment of chain occurs at much slower speed than diffusion of small segment. Because of this, polymeric materials show time-dependent deformation. So, in absence of external force, the typical forces which governs the morphology of the polymer chain is listed here. Due to these forces, chain remains in an entangled state and continuously collides with each other to form a lowest possible energy state. This state is a highly disordered form. When an external force is applied, it leads to alignment of some polymer chain in the force direction, whereas other chains tries to pull them back to original position through entanglement points. At small deformation, bond stretching and chain straightening can take place. Both this deformation is like stretching a spring, so they will return to its original shape once force is removed. On the other hand, if the polymer chain is deformed further or the load is applied for a long time, then chain breakage and chain slippage can occur. Both phenomena would result in a permanent change in the polymer morphology. As a result, when the force is removed, the chain will not be able to return to its original shape, and it will attain a new equilibrium state. In summary, we can say that bond stretching and chain straightening leads to elastic deformation, and chain slippage and chain breakage leads to plastic deformation. As polymer undergoes both these type of deformation under stress, the polymeric material shows viscoelastic behavior. It is very clear that the molecular mechanism of elastic and plastic deformation is not only complex but also extremely specific to a polymer, since it depends on chemical nature of the chain, molecular weight, percentage crystallinity, deformation type, and many other factors. So, to avoid the complication, scientists have developed different models to explain and understand the viscoelastic behavior of polymeric materials. Three of the most common models are Maxwell model, Kelvin-Voigt model, and standard linear viscoelastic model. The Maxwell model consists of a spring and a dashpot connected in series. The spring corresponds to elastic deformation and dashpot to viscous deformation. The creep and recovery behavior of Maxwell model can be represented by a very simple equation as shown here. We can see that when force is applied, there is an instantaneous deformation due to stretching of spring. Further deformation takes place due to deformation of dashpot. Once the force is removed, spring returns to its original shape, leading to recovery of the deformation. One limitation of this model is that it does not predict creep or constant stress condition accurately, because this model suggests that strain will increase linearly with time. However, polymers for the most part shows the strain rate decrease with time. Anyways, Maxwell model is very good in understanding the deformation and recovery behavior of soft solids like thermoplastic polymer in the vicinity of their melting point. Second model is Kelvin and Voigt model. In this model, spring and dashpot is connected in parallel. This model can also be represented by a very simple equation as shown in the slide. Here, we can see that once the force is applied, there is no instantaneous deformation since dashpot cannot deform instantaneously. At constant stress, the model is quite realistic as it predicts strain to decrease with time. Thus, the model is extremely good for modeling creep in materials. But with regards to relaxation, the model is much less accurate. However, this model can be used to predict the deformation behavior at low loading for organic polymers, rubber, and wood. A more complex but comprehensive model is SLV model. SLV model is the combination of Maxwell and Kelvin-Voigt model and represented by the equation shown in the slide. It is the simplest model that accurately describes both the creep and stress relaxation behavior of a viscoelastic material. Using these models, we can easily derive the spring constant and viscosity of the dashpot corresponding to a particular polymer, which can help us to predict the material behavior under different conditions. This is a very important aspect when designing a load-bearing structure. Here, we can see the simplified version of the viscoelastic equation representing different models. The simplified form shows the simple relationship between stress and strain. So, if the constants are given, then it will be very easy to calculate the deformation at different time. In exam, it is important that the units of this parameter should be in one form only. If you have any question, please comment below. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel, Polymer World, for more videos like this. Thank you.